Hey gang, it's Jeff with missionmusician.com. I'm shooting this video for a second time because I'm such an awesome engineer that I forgot to turn up the gain on my microphone when I shot this video the first time. So, Pro Tools has had track presets since I think Pro Tools 9, and I am just finding out about it today. Shows you how much in the loop I am. This is awesome. I don't know why I didn't know about this. I just was reading some articles today on mixing and Pro Tools, and I just happened to stumble across an article on Pro Tools track presets. So what are Pro Tools track presets? Well, I would use a template, but you can use track presets. For example, let me go up here, track new, and I'm going to choose a stereo track. Now watch this. When I click on what type of track I want, I got a whole new list of things here I can select from. So if I want to have my two bus, I just click on submix, and here we go, two bus right here, and I hit create, and bam, this appears with VMR loaded up with what I want on the two bus, VBC loaded up with set to a 3-to-1 ratio, and this turned off and all ready to go, and VTM set up just the way I like it for my two bus. Okay, so this is super, super cool. Again, this isn't new by any means, but it's brand new to me, so I wanted to share it with you. For those of you who are not Pro Tools users, this isn't going to be very helpful to you. I generally don't post Pro Tools specific videos. As a matter of fact, I think I only have one on my YouTube channel, and that's for editing drums. So I apologize, but this is so cool that I wanted to make sure anyone out there with Pro Tools knows about this. So there are all kinds of videos showing how to set it up, and that's all great and dandy, but if you run into the same problem I had, you're going to be scratching your head for hours. So I want to show you how to do it, and again, this is going to be Windows specific as well as Pro Tools specific. There's plenty of stuff out there for Apple and Mac, I guess Apple and Mac are one and the same, aren't they? So let me show you how this is done. So let's say I wanted to have a bass track. Let's go to new, and I normally track bass. Well, I do track bass and mono, so I'm going to select a mono audio track. I'm going to hit create. I'm going to rename it bass. All right. And I normally leave bass this color, so that's what color it's going to be. I'm going to put an instance of VTM on it. Let's see, a VMR. Actually, you know what? I am going to put an instance of VTM on it. Harmonic, virtual tape machine, and I'm going to go to channel default. And let's see what we want to put in here. I'm going to put the FG76. I'm going to crank this up a little bit. I'm going to put the VCC, and I'm going to set it to the Brit N, and I'm going to crank that up a little bit. I am going to put FGS, and I'm going to roll the high pass up just a little bit. Let's say about 60. And I'm also going to throw in CS lift, and I'm going to throw in revival. So this is going to save this track preset just like this. And so actually, I think I'm getting ahead of myself here. All right, so let me show you how to do this first. So if you go to Documents in go into the Start tab and look for Documents, and then find your folder that says Pro Tools. You'll have a folder that says Pro Tools. In here, you want to right click, create a new folder. You want to title that folder Track Presets. It has to have the S on the end, okay? I'm going to go ahead and delete this. And if you click inside that folder, then you need to create some subfolders. So I have Instrument, Master, Submix, Vocals. I could create Bass, Synths. You create a new folder just by right-clicking and hitting Folder, and then you name it whatever you want. Okay, so that's what you need to do first before you create any tracks. And if you already have tracks created that have the plugins you want, just delete the audio on them and save the track as a preset. If you got something vibing, like I'm going to actually, you know what? I'm going to create a new folder called Reverb. And I'm going to save my Reverb track presets in here as well. All right, so I guess I could have named that Effects. But all right, so I'm going to close that. And then now you want to make sure the track that you want to save as a preset is selected. If you want to save a group of tracks, you know, you can select a different one as well. In this case, I'm just going to save this bass. Okay, so I come up here to File, and I go down to Export, and I go to Select Track as New Session. Excuse me. Don't even worry about anything in here. Just click OK. All right. Now it's going to ask you where you want to save it in. Well, you got to go to My Documents, then you got to scroll down to Pro Tools, double click that, then scroll down to Track Presets, double click that, and here's where all your subfolders are. So I'm going to select Instruments because bass is an instrument, and I'm going to title this Bass. All right, and I'm going to save it. Okay, now, right now, if I try to pull up, if I delete this and try to open that track, it will not open. So if I select New and Mono Audio Track, if I go down to Instruments, you can see I only have Electric Guitar 1 and Guitar 1. Bass isn't there. Okay, this is where I had my frustration, and hopefully I can clear it up for you. So if you go to your Documents folder and you go to Pro Tools and you go to Track Presets and you go to the track that you just saved, and mine would be under Instruments, you can see here it's saved as a PTX, and you got to change that PTX to PTXT. Now, by default, Windows 7 hides the extensions. Okay, so yours probably says Pro Tools Session or something like that. Session file. Yeah, Pro Tools Session file is what yours probably says if your extensions are hid. So I want to show you how to find those, because this is where I had a nightmare trying to figure this out. So if you go to Start on your computer, and in the search dialog there in your startup box, your start menu, type in folder options and hit enter. All right. Now, if you go to the view tab and you scroll down to where it says hide extensions for known file types, if I hit apply, I don't know if it's going to hide them. Yeah, see, it doesn't show the PTX there. So what you want to do is you want to uncheck that hide extensions for known file types and hit apply. And then hit OK. And then I'm going to rename this. And I'm just going to add a T on the very end after the X. All right, and I'm going to hit enter. And then I'm going to click yes. So now, if I go to track, new, whoops, sorry, hit the wrong thing there. Track, new, and I go to mono, and I click what type of track I want. If I go under instruments, right there, you see now that I have bass. And if I hit create, so now it has VTM on there the way I had it set up, and it's got VMR on there the way I had it set up. So this is awesome. This is going to be a great time saver for me. I'm super excited about it. I know that this is over 6 years old, this information. But like I said, I just found out about it today, and I am pumped about it. I am so happy about this. And so I don't know why Pro Tools doesn't just have, you know, that already in it to where you can create track presets. I really don't know why it's not already available without going through all that trouble of renaming the extensions and all that. But once you do it once, it's done, and you can create as many different types of track presets that you could think of for whatever you want. I love this. This is going to be awesome, and I'm going to go create a bunch of track presets here in a minute so I can just pull them up, boom, ready to go. All right, so I just wanted to share that with you today. If you like these types of videos, subscribe. Also, I wanted to make mention that over at the blog, there's quite a few new articles out. I don't just shoot videos, for those of you who don't know. I also write articles about recording and mixing. And I generally post all my YouTube videos over there, but I go into more detail in the description when I'm writing out a blog about the video I'm posting. So you may want to check that out if you feel like it. If not, that's okay too. So I will see you soon in a new video coming soon. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.